Somebody shouted an amen of victory.
Amen.
Somebody shout an amen of victory.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
An amen of victory.
Amen.
An amen of a miracle.
Amen.
An amen of celebration.
Amen.
Thank you, may be seated.
As
the Lord bless you, the Lord bless you. Amen.
Amen.
Who need deliverance? That is what we are studying and understanding. Who needs deliverance? Who needs deliverance? And who is a candidate of deliverance? There are a number of words in the Bible that we don't understand. Salvation.
Wokovu.
Redemption.
Ukombozi.
Deliverance. That is salvation.
Wokovu.
Redemption.
Ukombozi.
Deliverance.
Na kuwekwa huru.
All these are names.
Haya yote ni maneno.
That we need to know and understand them.
Ambayo tunafaa kuyajua na kuyaelewa.
The starting point in life of God is called salvation.
Na chanzo katika maisha ya Mungu ni wokovu.
Any time you start a walk with God is salvation.
Wakati unapoanza kutembea na Mungu utaanzia katika wokovu.
Bwana tukuzwe sana.
Amen.
Salvation is the beginning.
Wokovu ndio mwanzo.
But as you grow into the things of God,
lakini unapokuwa katika mambo ya Mungu,
you'll come across the words like deliverance.
Unakutana na mambo kama ukombozi.
Deliverance.
Ukombozi.
Deliverance.
Ukombolewa.
2 Timothy 4:18.
Timotheo wa pili 4:18.
Follow me step by step.
Unifuate hatua kwa hatua.
And the Lord shall deliver me.
Na Bwana atanikomboa.
Listen.
Sikiza.
Salvation is from sin.
Wokovu ni kutoka kwa dhambi.
And that is why John says, behold the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world.
Na ndipo Yohana anasema tazama mwana kondoo wa Mungu anayeondoa dhambi za ulimwengu.
That is salvation.
Huo ni wokovu.
Son of God that takes away the sins of the world.
Mwana kondoo wa Mungu anayeondoa dhambi za ulimwengu.
Then you come across another word, deliver.
Lakini unakutana na neno lingine ukombozi.
And the Lord shall deliver me.
Na Bwana atanikomboa.
The Lord shall deliver me.
Bwana atanikomboa.
This is very, very important. The Lord shall deliver me. When he talks about deliver me, what is he talking about? He will bring me out of every evil work. Salvation from sin. Deliverance is from evil works. Are you understanding? The Lord shall deliver me from every evil work. So when we talk about deliverance, we are talking about humanity coming out of evil works. Evil works. The activities of Satan in humanity. Afflictions and oppression. You are suppressed and oppressed. If you read about the deliverance of the children of Israel,
God
says, I have heard the cry of my people. I have seen their tears. And I have come down to deliver. I have come down to deliver them. I have come to set them free. So there are a number of things that the believers are supposed to be understanding in salvation and through salvation. So when he says, the Lord shall deliver me from evil works. The same evil works. Jesus mentioned it in the Lord's Prayer. But when you pray, you will say, deliver us from the evil one. As you say, our Father which art in heaven, you will end up by saying, deliver us from the evil one.
tumalizie kwa kusema tukomboe tokana na yule muovu.
So there is an evil one.
Kwa hivyo kuna yule muovu.
And there are evil works.
Na kuna kazi ovu.
And there cannot be evil works without an evil one.
Na hakuwezi kuwa na kazi ovu bila yule muovu.
And that is what we are talking about. Who needs deliverance?
Na hiyo ndio tunajifunza kwamba nani anayehitaji ukombozi.
In Luke chapter number 4 and verse 18.
Katika Luka 4:18.
The assignment of Jesus on earth.
Jukumu la Yesu Kristo duniani.
Very very crucial.
Ni muhimu sana.
The assignment of Jesus on earth.
Jukumu la Yesu duniani.
We can start from verse 16 or 15 there.
Tuanzie mstari wa 15 pale.
Jesus will not go to any altar.
Yesu hangeenda kwa madhabahu yoyote.
To deliver before he delivered his mission.
Kuwakomboa watu kabla hajakomboa kazi yake.
Verse 16.
Mstari wa 16.
The Bible says.
Nasema,
and he came to Nazareth. Where he had been brought up.
Akaenda Nazareti hapo alipolelewa.
He was not born here, he was brought up here.
Hakuzaliwa pale lakini alilelewa pale.
He was born in Bethlehem of Judea.
Alizaliwa katika Bethlehem ya Judea.
That is where he was born.
Pale ndipo alizaliwa.
He was brought up in Nazareth.
Lakini akalelewa Nazareti.
So he came where he was raised.
Sasa kaenda Nazareti mahali alipolelewa.
Where he was brought up.
Mahali alipolelewa.
And as his custom was.
Na kama ilivyokuwa.
He went into the synagogue.
Siku ya sabato akaingia katika sinagogi.
On a Sabbath day and stood up to read.
Akasimama ili asome.
The custom at that time.
Desturi wakati ule.
Every day of Sabbath.
Kila siku ya sabato.
They would read a certain scripture in the Bible.
Wangesoma andiko fulani katika Biblia.
And they had started the Isaiah. I mean the chronology or the following up of the book of Isaiah.
Na walikuwa wanajifundisha katika maandishi yake Isaiah.
In every Sabbath day they would read a chapter.
Na kila siku ya sabato wangesoma andiko.
So they had started Isaiah chapter 1.
Sasa walikuwa wameanzia Isaiah
chapter
2, wa pili,
chapter 3,
wa tatu,
chapter 4,
wa nne.
But the day Jesus came.
Lakini Yesu alipokuja.
His destiny and assignment collided with Isaiah.
Hatima yake ikagongana na Isaiah.
Where now Jesus want to read?
Sasa ambapo Yesu anataka kusoma.
In Luke chapter 4 verse 18.
Katika Luka 4:18.
And he says the spirit of the Lord is upon me.
Akasema kwamba roho wa Bwana yu juu yangu.
The spirit of the Lord is upon me.
Roho wa Bwana yu juu yangu.
Somebody says spirit of the Lord.
Sema roho wa Bwana.
Rest upon me.
Tua juu yangu.
So this particular time.
Sasa wakati huu
Jesus has opened Isaiah 61.
Yesu amefungua Isaiah 61.
Are you understanding?
Je, unaelewa?
He has opened Isaiah 61.
Amefungua Isaiah 61.
Because that day,
kwa sababu siku ile,
it was a day they were to read Isaiah 61.
Ilikuwa ni siku ambayo wangesoma Isaiah 61.
So the destiny of Jesus,
sasa hatima ya Yesu,
it collided with his mission.
Ikagongana na tume yake.
When he read that,
aliposoma hii.
And he said, the spirit of the Lord is upon me.
Nasema roho wa Bwana yu juu yangu.
Because he has anointed me.
Kwa maana amenitia mafuta.
He has anointed me.
Amenitia mafuta.
Number one, to preach the gospel to the poor.
Mwanzo kuwahubiria maskini habari njema.
There are a number of things Jesus was on assignment on earth.
Kuna mambo mengi ambayo Yesu alikuwa ametumwa kufanya duniani.
Number one is to deal with poverty.
Jambo la kwanza ni kushughulikia umaskini.
Somebody say every spirit of poverty.
Every spirit of poverty.
In my life.
In my life.
You shall release me.
You shall release me.
I can't hear you.
Siwasiki.
Somebody say powers of poverty.
Powers of poverty.
Pursuing me like a shadow.
You shall be broken.
So the first assignment was to bring down the powers of poverty. That is why he says, I am anointed to preach the gospel to the poor and tell the poor your days of poverty are coming to an end. I am anointed to tell the poor your days of struggling financially are over. That is what Jesus came to do. That is what the anointing does. It breaks the backbone of poverty. And that was the first assignment. To preach the gospel to the poor. To tell the poor, poverty is not your garment. I said, poverty is not your inheritance. inheritance. And I pray for somebody. You are saying a poverty enough is enough. I say poverty enough is enough. May you escape from that prison. I say may you escape from that prison. So assignment number one was to lift up men from poverty, translate them back to the Garden of Eden. That was the assignment. Because after man's fall, he was chased out of the garden because of the failure of the first Adam. Number two, the second Adam, who is Jesus, he was now to take man back to Eden to enjoy what man was enjoying from the beginning. The first man fell in a garden. In a garden. The second Adam won the battle in a garden of Gethsemane. You didn't hear that. The first Adam, he failed in the Garden of Eden. The second Adam, he won the battle on his knees at the Garden of Gethsemane. And I am here to tell somebody, the blood that came out like sweat, he was paying the price that was the
Hallelujah.
You didn't hear me. It was in the Garden of Gethsemane, the battle was won, that you will never be poor, that poverty will be destroyed. The first Adam, he lost the war in the Garden of Eden. The second Adam, he won the battle in the second garden, the Garden of Gethsemane. And I pray for somebody here today. May poverty be laid to rest. I say poverty will be laid to rest. Somebody shout yes. Hey, you don't have to suffer poverty. That was the first assignment. To preach the gospel to the poor. The second thing, he says, I am anointed to heal the brokenhearted. I said to somebody, I don't know what has broken your heart. Is it a relationship? Is it your marriage? Whatever has broken your heart, he came to heal the brokenhearted. And today I pray, I don't know what report you carry. I don't know what the doctors have said. They may have said an information that has broken your heart. You don't see how you shall live. I am here to tell somebody, for this purpose, Jesus came to heal the brokenhearted. To heal the brokenhearted. That was assignment number two. Number three, it was to preach deliverance. To preach deliverance. Hey, to preach deliverance. And that is what we do here. Preaching deliverance. That is assignment number three. To preach deliverance. Who was he preaching deliverance to? Preach deliverance to the captives. Hey, somebody say, I break every captivity. I break every captivity. So there are people who are captives. And especially believers. Believers. They are captive of curses they are not aware of. They are not even aware. There is an existing curse. They don't understand. They are a captive. captive of a specific condition. There is a curse oppressing them. An evil thing around their body, their spirit, and their soul. They can't understand why they are greeted with failure. They are greeted with failure where others are greeted with success. I pray for somebody here. You will be greeted with success. I say you will be greeted with success. Many people don't understand why they are using a lot of energy on profitless hard work. There is a power oppressing you. You are not aware that you are a captive. You don't understand you are a captive. You are laboring under a burden of backwardness. You are going backward year after year. People you went to school with, they are driving and you are walking. People you went to school with, they travel abroad monthly. You can't explain because there is a power that makes you labor under closed heaven. You are a captive of hard labor. You are laboring under closed heaven. What you do does not resemble your harvest. Somebody said today,
sema leo,
I come out of captivity.
Natoka gerezani.
I am coming out of captivity.
Natoka kifungoni.
Your sweat is not sweet.
Jasho lako halina utamu.
Your sweat is not sweet.
Jasho lako siyo tamu.
You can't admire your sweat.
Haufurahi jasho lako.
When the Bible says,
Biblia inaposema,
and you shall eat the good of the land.
Ya kwamba utakula mema ya nchi.
You are eating the frustrations of life.
Sasa unakula fedheha ya maisha.
Today I put a full stop.
Leo hii nakomesha.
I said today I put a full stop.
Leo nakomesha.
Any man under captivity,
mtu yoyote aliye chini ya kifungo,
and the sound of my voice, may that devil release you. May that devil release you. I say, may that devil release you. Many people are captives. Ezekiel 1:1. Ezekiel was a man who could prophesy to bones and they would rise up. Listen to this. Now it came to pass that in the 13th year, in the 4th month, in the 5th day of the month, as I was among the captives, I was among the captives, miongoni mwa mateka.
Amen.
Hey, Ezekiel is a prophet,
Ezekiel ni nabii,
but he's among the captives.
Lakini yuko miongoni mwa mateka.
You are a believer,
wewe ni muuminio,
but you are among those who have HIV.
Lakini wewe ni miongoni mwa walio na ukimwi.
You are a believer,
wewe ni muuminio,
but you are among those who have sugar diabetes.
Lakini wewe una kisukari.
The devil is a liar.
Shetani ni
muongo. You shall escape that captivity.
Utatoka kwenye hicho kifungo.
I say you shall escape.
Utatoka.
He says I was among those who were under captive, those that were arrested. I am a prophet, but I was among the poor. There are people here who are under poverty, and you are a believer. You are educated, you are beautiful, but what you carry in your body does not equal your effort. Can you raise your hand in anger? Somebody say, my Father, my God.
My Father, my God.
I can't hear you.
My Father, my
louder
God.
Than your neighbor.
My Father, my God.
Today, I break the prison.
I break the prison.
I break the prison.
I break the prison.
Hey, You may not want to pray now.
Wewe usitake kuomba leo.
But sooner or later.
Lakini hivi karibuni.
You will ask people.
Utawauliza watu.
The prayers I heard them pray.
Maombi niliyosikia wakiomba.
What were they saying?
Walikuwa kisema nini?
That time you have found a tortoise on your bed.
Wakati utakuwa umepata mzee kobe kwa kitanda chako.
That's when you will start looking for these prayers.
Can
you raise your hand, somebody? Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
Every family curse.
Every family curse.
Punishing my life.
Punishing my
Where
life.
Are you?
Where are you?
Break it now.
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 Break
it now.
Break
it now. I was among the captives. In other words, I am working so hard without corresponding results. The results are different. Why? I am a captive.
Kwa sababu mimi ni mateka.
I am a captive.
Mimi ni mateka.
Listen to this. When this man realized
Sasa huyu mtu alipogundua
I was a captive
ya kwamba mimi nilikuwa mateka
and was sitting by a river called Chebar.
Na alikuwa ameketi kando ya mtu unaitwa Chebar.
The heavens were open.
Mbingu zikafunguka.
The day heavens open.
Mbingu zilipofunuka.
You'll come out of captivity.
Unatoka kwenye mateka.
I said the day your heaven open.
Nasema mbingu zako
zitakapofunguka. Jump out of captivity. Somebody say, kila umateka.
Kila umateka.
Mahali nimefungwa.
Mahali nimefungwa.
Niachilie.
Niachilie.
Hey, the day heavens open.
Wakati mbingu zilifunuka.
That was the time he was coming out of this captivity.
Hapo ndo alianza kutoka kwenye
He saw the visions of God.
Akaona maono ya Mungu.
He saw the visions of God.
Akaona maono ya Mungu.
Many times when we are in captivity,
wakati mwingi tukiwa kifungoni,
you experience what I call reoccurrence of trouble.
Unapitia kile ambacho nakiita shida zinajirudia.
Reoccurring troubles.
Shida za kujirudia.
Reoccurrence of mistakes.
Makosa ya kujirudia.
Trouble keep pursuing you.
Mateso yanakuandama.
You can't explain why does this sickness appear every April.
Hauelewi ni kwa nini ugonjwa unakuja kila mwezi wa 4.
Why is it that every December there is a sickness?
Ni kwa nini kila December kuna ugonjwa?
You suffer a reoccurrence of evil things.
Unateswa na vitu viovu vya kujirudia.
You are arrested by what I call retrogression, backwardness.
Unashikwa na kile ambacho nakita kurudi nyuma.
You live in a life of worry and anxiety.
Unaishi katika maisha ya woga na wasiwasi.
You encounter failure even in the middle of success.
Unakutana na kushindwa hata ukiwa katikati mwa fanaka.
In the middle of success.
Katikati mwa fanaka.
You still encounter failure.
Bado unakutana na kushindwa.
I'm coming out today.
Natoka leo.
Somebody say I'm coming out today.
Sema ninatoka.
Somebody say I am coming out
Sema
today.
Natoka.
Hey, Bwana tukuzwe sana.
Amen.
You trek for a long time.
Unatembea muda mrefu.
Before your life takes off to another level.
Kabla ya maisha yako kuinuka hadi kiwango kingine.
We are calling it captivity.
Tunaita umateka.
Jesus came to preach deliverance.
Yesu alikuja kuhubiri ukombozi.
To the captives.
Kwa walio mateka.
People are in captivity.
Watu wako matekani.
And one sign to show you are in captivity is lack of favor.
Na ishara moja kukuonyesha uko katika mateka ni kukosa kibali.
Lack of favor.
Kutopendelewa.
And when you don't have favor, nobody can notice you.
Ya kwamba kama upendelewi, hakuna mtu atakutambua.
When you don't have favor,
ukikosa kupendelewa,
nobody can look at you twice.
Hakuna mtu atakutazama mara mbili.
Hey. You have a mega business.
Una biashara kubwa.
But because of lack of favor,
lakini kwa sababu ya kukosa kibali,
you stay there the whole day watching Facebook.
Uko pale mchana mzima ukiangalia
lack of favor.
Kukosa kibali.
Lack of favor.
Kukosa kibali.
It is a sign you are a captive.
Ni ishara ya kwamba wewe ni mateka.
When you are not able to complete your goals.
Wakati huwezi timiza malengo yako.
You can't accomplish or achieve anything.
Hauwezi kamilisha chochote.
It is a sign you are under captivity.
Ni ishara ya kwamba wewe ni mateka.
I pray for somebody today.
Namuombea mtu hapa
leo. You shall escape that captivity.
Ya kwamba utatoka kwenye
You shall escape that captivity.
Utatoka kwenye huo mateka.
Isaiah chapter 5:13.
Isaiah 5:13.
God speaks about his own people.
Yeah, Mungu anaongea kuhusiana na watu wake.
He's talking about his own people.
Anaongea kuhusiana na watu wake.
Ezekiel was a captive.
Ezekiel alikuwa mateka.
A prophet.
Nabii.
I have seen people in hospitals.
Nimeona watu hospitalini.
They are admitted.
Wamelazwa.
One hand they are holding their Bible.
Mkono mmoja wamebeba Biblia.
And on one hand they have a drip.
Na mkono mwingine wanawekwa maji.
Your salvation does not correspond with your circumstance.
Wokovu wako haufanani na hali yako.
Somebody say, I break the shame.
I break the shame.
Can you say, my father, my father?
Sema, my father, my father.
Take away the shame.
Take away the shame.
Take away the shame.
Take away the shame.
Hey, are you understanding?
Amen.
The Lord says,
Bwana anasema,
therefore, my people,
kwa sababu hiyo watu wangu,
they are gone into captivity.
Wamechukuliwa mateka.
They are already in captivity.
Tayari yao ni mateka.
Because of a simple reason.
Kwa sababu ndogo.
They have no knowledge.
Kwa kukosa kuwa na maarifa.
They have no understanding.
Hawana kuelewa.
Hey, my people,
watu wangu,
they lack information.
Wanakosa maarifa.
They don't have understanding.
Hawaelewi.
Hey. And because of that,
na kwa sababu hiyo,
they have gone into captivity.
Wamechukuliwa mateka.
They are honorable men.
Na watu wao wenye cheo.
Hey, people that are educated.
Watu ambao wamesoma.
Because of captivity.
Kwa sababu ya umateka.
They can't get jobs.
Hawawezi pata kazi.
They are honorable men.
Watu wao wenye cheo.
Beautiful women.
Wake warembo.
Who have babies who don't know their fathers.
Ambao wana watoto baba zao hawajulikani.
Why?
Kwa nini?
Honorable. They are famished and their multitude dry up with thirst.
Wanajaa na wengi wao wana kiu sana.
They are destroyed.
Wameharibiwa.
Number one, because of lack of knowledge.
Kwa sababu kukosa maarifa.
They have gone into captivity.
Wameingia katika umateka.
Hey, we are here to get knowledge that will keep you out of captivity.
Tuko hapa kupata maarifa ambayo yatakutoa kwenye umateka.
Somebody say, I am coming out.
Sema ninatoka.
Somebody say, I'm coming out.
I'm coming out.
Hey. So Jesus' mission was to preach the gospel to the poor, heal the brokenhearted. Number three, to preach deliverance. What is deliverance? This is the mandate of deliverance churches in Kenya.
Look for 18. Luke 4:18
is the mandate of deliverance churches in Kenya. Yo tume la kanisa na ukombozi hapa Kenya. This is not a motivational preaching.
Sasa huu sio uchumbo kutia moyo.
I say scatter by thunder.
Nasema tawanyika.
It is a warfare zone.
Ni mahali pa vita.
Manielewa?
Amen.
This mountain
Mlima huu
is a warfare zone.
Ni unga wa vita.
That is why we are here.
Na ndio sababu
that every curse in your life.
Ya kwamba kila laana maisha
yako. Every sorcerer.
Kila mganga.
Every witch.
Kila mchawi.
Must regret in your life.
Lazima ajute.
We are not here to pity anyone.
Hatuko hapa kumhurumia.
We are here to tell your enemies.
Tuko hapa kuambia
maadui zako. Your days are over.
Ya kwamba siku zako.
Whoever dug a grave for you.
Ya kuchimbia kaburi.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Whoever said you can't be married, I prophesy you will be married. Whoever said you will die barren, the devil is a liar. I break barrenness. I break barrenness. I break barrenness. Whoever swore standing on their feet, I stand on my feet. I swear today, your enemies will die. Your enemies will die. In the name of Jesus. Ah.
Amen.
This is a military base. So we don't come here to pray ice cream prayers. We are here to make sure that any man or woman, dead or alive, that swore you can't handle 1,000, they will be laid to rest. They will be laid to rest in the name of Jesus. This is a military zone, and I don't care who prophesied against your life. Whoever swore from an altar that you can't prosper until you follow them, I am here to tell you, the devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. If I be an oracle of God, whoever swore you cannot prosper until you are under their mercy, today, I command them to release you. I command them to release you. They shall release you. Somebody shall fire. You are not under the mercy of Satan. You are under the mercy of grace. Today, may this grace disgrace your enemy. In the name of Jesus, be seated. My people. Hey, when I look at this word, my people, it talks about you that believes in God. Look at Joel 2:26. My people. My people. Hey, Jesus Christ. Verse 25. Go back 25. 24, there's something I wanted to say here. And the floor shall be full of wheat.
Na sakavu za kupepetea zitajaa ngano.
Hewele. And the floor shall be full of wheat.
Na sakavu za kupepetea zitajaa ngano.
And the fat shall overflow with wine and oil.
Na mashinikizo yatafurika kwa divai na mafuta.
And I will restore.
Nami nitawarudishia.
I will restore.
Nitawarudishia.
May God begin to restore.
Mungu anze kurudisha.
What your mother-in-law wasted.
Kile mama mko alipoteza.
What your boyfriend wasted.
Kile mpenzi wako alipoteza.
May God restore.
Mungu na akurudishie.
He says, and I will restore to
Nami
you.
Nami nitawarudishia.
Hey, what will I restore?
Nitawarudishia nini?
The years the locust have withered.
Hiyo miaka iliyoliwa na nzige.
The years the locust have swallowed.
Hiyo miaka
canker worms,
na parare,
caterpillar,
na madumadu,
palmer worms,
na tunutu,
which is a greater me I send among
you.
And you shall eat in plenty and be satisfied and praise the name of the Lord your God, who has dealt wondrously with you and my people. Hey, how many people of God are here? He says, and my people shall never be ashamed. May your shame expire. May your shame expire.
Hey.
Ah.